Go to stufftoblowyourmind.com to enter the Science Awards contest and a chance to win a $10,000 college scholarship sponsored by BASF, the chemical company. Water plus air plus sun equals jet fuel? Well, yeah, that's a thing we can officially say now. Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and we did it! We have successfully created jet fuel out of thin air. And by we, I mean a team of highly specialized chemists, obviously. Researchers from the Solar Jet Project have found a way to create kerosene using only water, air, and sunlight. And if you don't think that's amazing, then I don't know what to tell you. The basic idea is this. They combine water and carbon dioxide, and then they use simulated concentrated sunlight to convert that into syngas, which is a gas made up of hydrogen, carbon monoxide, and oxygen. They then use the Fischer-Tropsch process, which is a chemical process invented in Germany in the 1920s, to convert the syngas into kerosene so it can be used as fuel. It's a simple idea, right? Yes, but it's been hard to accomplish until now for two main reasons. One, the dissociation of carbon dioxide in water only happens at extremely high temperatures, around 4,000 degrees Fahrenheit. So to achieve that, they used a high-flux solar simulator that mimics the output from a solar concentrator. So it gets insanely hot. Problem solved. The other issue is that the Fischer-Tropsch process, which converts the syngas into kerosene, can cause a massive explosion if the oxygen isn't completely removed from the syngas first. This problem was solved by using ceria, which is a chemical compound that releases oxygen when heated above 2700 degrees Fahrenheit. So when you heat up the ceria, all of that oxygen gets released and you're left with this reduced form of ceria. You then add that to the water and carbon dioxide, so when you heat all of them up together, the oxygen given off by the dissociation of water and carbon dioxide gets absorbed back into the ceria. And that process gets repeated over and over again, so eventually you end up with syngas that is completely oxygen-free, at which point you can safely convert that into fuel. As amazing as this process is, the team who discovered it has only produced a single glass of kerosene thus far, but they estimate that a full-scale solar reactor could produce up to 20,000 liters of jet fuel every single day. Above all else, they say it's an important milestone in the long-term process of developing a truly sustainable alternative fuel future. It uses infinite materials we already have and turns harmful ones like carbon dioxide into actual useful resources. What could be better than that? Not much, I tell you. Not much. I think this is incredible personally, and I hope you guys agree. As always, if you have comments, questions, anything about this episode you want to say, leave them down below and subscribe here for more videos.